that is, if determinant is non-zero, then A is invertible. Now, from this, we are going to derive a formula also to calculate the inverse of a matrix very quickly. To derive this formula, if determinant of A is non-zero, then the inverse exists. That is a condition. So, let's prove it, and through this proving only, we'll get the formula. So, we have done this first property. We'll just recall the first property we did in one of the videos was A into adjoint of A equal to determinant of A. This was the first property that we discussed today. So, this property of the adjoint, we've written it here. Throughout, because as determinant of A is non-zero, so we can divide by a non-zero quantity throughout in this equation. We can divide by this non-zero. Equation mein agar aap ekhi quantity se, same quantity se divide kare, the equation remains unchanged. So, dividing by determinant of A throughout, what do we get? A times adjoint of A upon determinant of A equal to this A times determinant of this, we can put A times this determinant of A cancels out, adjoint of A into determinant of A into A. So what do we get? A into adjoint of A upon determinant of A equal to I equal to adjoint of A upon determinant of A into A. Just recall, ye the result kisse match kar raha hai? AB equal to I equal to BA. जहाँ पे B क्या है, A का इनवर्स. ये डेफिनेशन ऑफ इनवर्स पे बैठ बिल्कुल सूटेबली सूट कर रहा है. इट्स वेरी सूटिंग टू द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ऑफ द डेफिनेशन ऑफ द इनवर्स ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स. A इनटू दिस इक्वल टू I इक्वल टू दिस मैट्रिक्स इनटू I. इस मैट्रिक्स को हम नाम दे देते हैं B फॉर द टाइमिंग. दिस इज B. सो ए बी इक्वल टू आई, बी इक्वल टू आई मीन्स वॉट? बी इज द इनवर्स ऑफ ए. फ्रॉम हियर वीव गॉट द फॉर्मूला ऑफ द इनवर्स ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला. बी इज द इनवर्स ऑफ ए हियर. So, the formula of the inverse is adjoint of A upon determinant of A. We can note down adjoint of A upon determinant of A. This is the formula to calculate the inverse of any matrix. Now, you don't have to use elementary row transformation if it is not mentioned in the question. So, if you have not been given elementary transformations in the question, you can find the inverse of a matrix by dividing adjoint of that matrix by its own determinant. So matrix will have an inverse if and only if determinant of A is non-zero or A is non-singular. So condition for the existence of the inverse is A should be non-singular or the determinant of A should be non-zero. We can find out inverse by using this formula. You can try out questions of 4.5 using this formula and get the inverse of the matrix A.